Hello everyone, welcome back to our study of mind rubrics. So let's study our rubric for today, and that is ardent. So what is ardent? Ardent is a person who has very intense feelings, very strong feelings towards something, who is very passionate, very intense about whatever they do. So this is the dictionary meaning of the word ardent. It means someone who has extremely strong feelings about something. Very strong feelings for something, and it is characterized by intense desire and passionate. So I am very passionate about homeopathy. So every day I will study about it, every day I will read about it, every day I will try and see patients and work hard for those patients, or every day I will try to make some videos to gain knowledge, to improve knowledge, to excel in it, to because there is a lot of interest, a lot of motivation. I am very, very motivated and interested and enthusiastic about homeopathy, very highly interested, very too engrossed in it and very interested in it. This is passion, that is intense desire to do something. So ardent means intense. So this intensity can be with, you know, like I told you, with homeopathy, but it can be also seen in some, for example, there is a cricket fan. A person is a huge fan of cricket, so he will go and watch each and every cricket match in the stadium, or he will make sure that he will watch it, every single ball on the television, and he will also watch the highlights, and he will also watch the pre-match telecast, also the post-match telecast. Then he will ask questions, then he will interact with people, talk over it. So you see, he has a very, very deep interest in cricket. That is deep interest. Or you are a huge fan of Shah Rukh Khan, so you want to watch every movie of his, you want to know everything about him, you have posters of him all over your house, you intensely are in love with him and are really interested and really go about doing everything considering what he or she is doing, what your star is doing, like a cricket fan. And they just cannot have enough. The more and more they have, they feel more they want, even more they want. They are deeply, deeply interested. So it is like a very deep love or a very deep affection towards a particular thing. And you are very highly enthusiastic and interested to do it, to just do it. I just want to do it. I want more. I want to do homeopathy. I want to watch this movie. I want to watch this cricket match. I want to win this tournament. So intense desire, passionate about it. And here what is important in ardent is the word intense. Very, very intense. Intense pain. Too much. Oh, the pain in such patients is also very intense. It is too much. I cannot take it. I cannot tolerate it. It's too much. Very intense pain. Very intense sadness. I cannot tolerate this sadness. Like you saw in this movie, this man has heard that he has lost someone. The grief is too much for him. The sadness of that loss is too much. He is not able to tolerate it. It's too intense. He's very angry, you know, very angry in that I cannot tolerate my anger. I cannot stay with it. I can't stay calm with it. I have to do something. It's too intense, my anger. I may hit someone. I will shout in my anger. If I am happy, I am very happy. You just can't stop my happiness. I will express, I will talk, I will do very intense, whatever. You see, you may seem that this patient is very moody, intense, happy if they win the cricket match, if the movie of the star is a huge hit, very, very happy, very elated. If it flops, if they don't, very down, become sad. So, you see, intense, either very happy or very sad, very painful or no pain. Intense, everything is very intense. So, the word here to remember is intense. So, there's only one remedy in this rubric, and that is Nux Vomica. In Kent's repertory, there is only one remedy, and Nux Vomica. And we know Nux Vomica has intense desire to do something, to conquer, to become some huge personality, very, very highly interested in whatever they do. They suddenly become passionate about business, and then they want to just do business day in, day out, morning, evening, night. They have meetings, parties, and everything is about business, business, and only business. So intense and very great interest in doing that thing. And you will see this intense interest or desire in other aspects also. Nux Vomica has very intense desire for spicy food, for alcohol, for stimulants, very intense. If they don't get the food, they will throw things. They'll hit you. They'll scream. They'll yell. How could you not give me this food? So I remember one patient. He just did not like eating dal. No, he just did not like dal rice. And his mother every day used to make dal rice for everybody at the house. So the moment he would say that other than the chapati and the curry, the mother has also made some dal, he would get so angry that he would just push the plate of his food away. He will start screaming at his mom, how could you do this? How could you make dal rice? I just don't like it. How could you do that? I can't even look at it. How could you bring that dal in front of you? I can't even look at it. I just hate it. So you see, intense hate, intense love. I just love spicy. So it has to be there. How could you not prepare spicy food? You have to. You just have to do it. This have to do it. Have to get it. This is Nux Vomica. Have to, and I have to get it now. They are very intense. They have to achieve it. I have to become a rich man. I have to become first in my exam. I have to have this food. I have to go here. I have to go and marry this girl. This compulsion, an intense compulsion that I have to watch this movie. I have to go to this cricket match. This is Nux Vomica. And similarly, Nux Vomica has other complaints which are also very intense. So after having this food, after having this alcohol, after partying, having so many meetings, exhausting your body, forgetting your body's needs in your passion or intensity to do things, you fall ill. And then again there, when Nux Vomica patient falls ill, you see intense symptoms. Intense chills, morning 3 a.m., 4 a.m., they wake up with very intense chills. The whole body is shivering, it's trembling, it's like moving. Even 3-4 coverings is not enough. They just can't tolerate the slightest draft of air, slightest. Even the door or the window being open in the other room is not intolerable, is intolerable. To Nux Vomica, they can't tolerate that even in the other room the window is open. That also even slightly, they can even sense that there's slight draft of air coming from there. They cannot tolerate. It's the topmost chili remedy in our material, the topmost. After that comes hip ourselves. too chilly. I just cannot tolerate the slightest draft of air. Shivering, intense. Along with that, intense loose motions. I feel like going, I'm trying, I want to get it out, but it's not going, it's not coming out. My stools are not coming out properly. That is nafs vomika. So this is how nafs vomika's intense desire or this ardent rubric is. When you see intense desire. So one of the cross references for ardent is fanatism. Fanatism means what? You are again very intensely interested in something, very deeply interested in something, very deeply enthusiastic of something. But the problem in fanatism is that you become irrational. I am very, very passionate about homeopathy, but my passion is becoming so much now that I feel that there is no other system that should be practiced. Only homeopathy should be there. Allopathy should be banned. Hospitals should be shut down. Ayurveda should be shut down. The only truth in life is homeopathy. This is fanatism. This is madness. This is irrational. You may be interested in something. You should be passionate. You can be passionate and you may like it. But you cannot say that the other thing is wrong. Only Shah Rukh Khan's movie should be released. No other hero's movie should be released. This is fanatism. This is madness. Only my religion is true. All other religion is false. This is the commonest form of fanatism that we see. Religious fanatism. People go crazy. They believe other religions are untrue. They become violent. They can kill to prove in their madness that only their thing is true. The other thing is false. This irrational behavior and getting into violence and hitting and striking, that is fanatism. Killing. Fanatic. You're mad. In politics, you kill people. You don't belong to my party. You don't agree with my ideology. I will kill you. That is fanatism. So, this is what I had for all of us today. I hope you liked it. We really look forward for your feedback, your suggestions. I know I'm not able to reply to every single comment that comes, but we really value your comments and your feedbacks. Look forward for your comments. Thank you. See you all soon. Bye-bye.